What's up, guys? My name's Hugh Miller, and today I'm going to tell you about a contest that I'm hosting. I'm going to start off by saying Her Interactive is in no way associated with, endorsing, or sponsoring this contest. I'm providing all the prizes from my own personal funds. It's all me. Her Interactive has nothing to do with this, just me. Anyways, I just finished writing a book on how to play the Nancy Drew games. It's loaded with tips, tricks, and solutions on how to solve many of the hardest puzzles and minigames. It's like mini golf and slider puzzles and that weird stone puzzle in Labyrinth of Lies, all that good stuff. However, I am missing one thing. It's kind of a major asset, and that is the artwork. And I've made a lot of the graphics. Actually, sorry, not a lot. I've made all the graphics, all the little images and whatnot that help illustrate my point for various puzzles. There's absolutely nothing in this book that was made by Her Interactive. There may be a few things that look a lot like something that Her Interactive made, but I legitimately remade every single image, made every single image. It's all me. When I'm saying artwork, I mean really nice looking fan art. And this contest is just an artwork contest, specifically the cover of the book. I don't have that art yet because I wanted to do something kind of special. I didn't want to just take text and say, da 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 da, by Hugh Miller. I want to be like, this is fan-made art. It's super cool. I just wanted the whole book to be 100% fan-made, so I just thought, why not get other fans involved with the project, Anyways, what I'm looking for the cover is that I want the cover art to speak Nancy Drew. You need to look at it, and you need to be like, that's Nancy Drew right away. It's got to pop out, stand out. Obviously nothing inappropriate. It's got to be something that's really, it's strongly Nancy Drew, it's also got to refer to the amazing title that I've come up with. Get ready for this. Here it comes. 3, 2, 1. How to Be a Detective. Not bad, huh? I thought I was pretty smart myself. The cover art can be in any style. When I say any style, I mean it can be modern. It can look kind of like the classic Nancy Drew cover arts. It can be like the game cover arts. It can really be any style you want. It could just be black and white. I really don't care. It just needs to be 100% your work. Can't be copied. Cannot be emulating another piece of art. It needs to be all you, completely original. I prefer stuff that's new, not stuff that was made beforehand, but if it's made beforehand and it's really good and it kind of gets the point across, then by all means. Because I've seen some really, really banging work. I've seen a lot of great artists in the Nancy Drew community make some really, really solid stuff. I'd love to have some of that as the cover art and other art in the book. But what's the point of this? Why is this, what's in it for you? Well, let me tell you. There'll be three winners for this contest. There's gonna be one grand prize winner and two runner-ups. All right. And since I'm saving for university and going there this fall, I can't afford stupid expensive prizes. But I can afford prizes that I think are pretty awesome. So the grand prize is the artist who I choose. Okay, the cover art that I choose, that artist will get their cover art as the full cover art on the book. They're going to get credit in the book. They can get a physical copy of the book, and it can be signed by me if they should so wish. And they will get a digital copy of Midnight in Salem. So, in my opinion, those prizes aren't too shabby. I'd be stoked. I'd be like, ooh, free copy of Mid? Heck yeah. And a book? Heck yeah. It's, just by the way, the book is over 200 pages. So, I'm not skimping out here. And the two runner-ups will get their artwork featured somewhere inside the book. Obviously not as the cover art, but just as, look at this amazing artwork that this person did. And it's going to have their name and whatnot. As well as a digital copy of any Nancy Drew game they want. And so that, of course, the list is from 1 to 32. And if they want Midnight in Salem, then by all means, that can be their choice. But overall, I think it's not a bad contest. I think it's pretty solid. Let's go over the main rules of the contest now. So it starts today, Monday, May 13th, 2019, and runs all the way until Wednesday, May 22nd, 2019. So that's next week. You can submit as many entries as you want. Like, if you want to just crank out a bunch of artwork and just hope one of them wins, by all means. Most likely, if it doesn't win, it's going to go in the book somewhere. Because I got a lot of empty pages that I've... It was just a whole, like, design thing that I did. And it's what it is. The ways to enter the contest are as follows. You can either post your submission on Twitter with a hashtag detective cover art and tag me at @_HughMiller. You can directly send it to me through a Twitter DM through @_HughMiller. Or if you don't have Twitter, you can email it to me at nanwalkthroughs@gmail.com. Yes, I finally got a Nancy Drew Walkthroughs official Gmail account. Best day ever. So yeah, we got some cool stuff here. With the subject line, cover art contest. For those of you guys that are overseas or international, I am so sorry, but just due to costs and whatnot, the contest is only open to US and Canadian residents. You can be any age you want. You could be 5 and enter this contest. You could just come out of the womb, draw something, and say, boom, there's my entry. There's no limit to the age. There's no limit to the age, no limit to the submissions. It's just only open to US and Canada. And I apologize for that, but I just don't have that kind of money to go spend shipping things overseas, unfortunately. Anyways, in regards to the actual cover art that you design, if the image was drawn on paper, it needs to be scanned and it needs to be sent at 300 DPI or higher. Just because that's like, it'll look the best on the front cover when it gets printed. If the image is digital, it needs to be sent at also 300 DPI or higher. When you draw the image by hand, or if you draw it digitally, the image has got to be minimum 11.75 by 8.75 inches. Oh, excuse me, I burped. Oh, at 300 DPI. That is the minimum. I would prefer bigger, obviously, just because it'll just look way nicer. But ultimately, yeah, that's about it. Anyway, yeah, that's the contest, guys. I think it's pretty rad. Design the cover art, and if you win, you get a copy of the book, your art and name featured on the front cover, plus Midnight in Salem. Like, what on earth is not to like about this book? And this book is super cool. And I'm not just saying that because I wrote it. It is actually a really cool book. And I think it'd be great for, if you're introducing someone to the games, you can say, here's all these games, and then here's a book with all these puzzles, and I don't just tell you the solutions to these puzzles. I walk through each step of most of the puzzles. I personally think it's a really solid book, and I think it's going to be something that a Nancy Drew fan would want. I mean, I want one. And it's not even 100% finished yet. It still needs to go through the editing process, and all the artwork needs to be put in and whatnot. So it's not done yet, but I really want one. So I'll tell you that. Anyways, it's all in your hands now. Go out there and create great pieces of art. I'll announce the winners on Thursday, May 23rd. I'll get back to the winners when they win. So good luck to everybody. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And I'll see you in the next video. Have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful rest of your day.